This lecture will cover the topic the skin of mammals. The notable features of mammalian skin are hair, different types of epidermal glands, highly stratified cornified epidermis, and the dermis is many times thicker than the epidermis. Layers of mammalian skin. The epidermis of mammalian skin is composed of stratified squamous epithelium and consists of several layers of variety of cells. Squamous epithelium is the layer of flat cells like this. This is the diagram of skin of mammals, and here this is the epidermis, which is made up of a squamous epithelium and it is stratified. Layers of epidermis. The epidermis contains the outer layer, which is named as stratum corneum. Stratum corneum is the layer made up of keratinized cells, and these keratinized cells make up the outer skin layer, which is named as stratum corneum. In this diagram, this is the epidermis of mammals, and it is made up of different layers of cells. The outer layer is named as stratum corneum. Functions of stratum corneum. Because keratin is virtually insoluble in water, the stratum corneum prevents dehydration, and it is a first line of defense against many toxic substances and microorganisms. Stratum malphigium. This is the stratum malphigium, which is present below stratum corneum, and it is composed of living cells. These cells continuously divide and form stratum corneum. The next layer of mammalian skin is dermis. The thickest portion of mammalian skin is composed of dermis. Dermis contain blood vessels, lymphatic vessels, nerve endings, hair follicles, small muscles and glands. Like in this diagram, this is the skin of mammals, and here it is the dermis. And this dermis contains blood vessels, nerve fibers, glands and muscles. Layers of mammalian skin. Dermis. Dermis of mammal is very useful. A special tanning process makes leather from the dermal layer of mammalian skin. The next layer of mammalian skin is hypodermis. Hypodermis consists of loose connective tissue, adipose tissue and skeletal muscle. Here this is the hypodermis, and it contains adipose tissue and skeletal muscles and loose connective tissues. Blood vessels thread from the hypodermis, as these are visible here. These are the blood vessels, and they thread from the hypodermis to the dermis, and they are absent in the epidermis. Adipose tissue store energy in the form of fat and provides insulation in cold environments. Skeletal muscle allows the skin above it to move somewhat independently of underlying tissues. Connective tissues form ground tissues in the dermis. Functions of mammalian skin. In humans and a few other animals like horses, the skin regulates body temperature by opening and closing sweat pores in a process called perspiration or sweating. Skin also screens out excessive harmful ultraviolet rays from the skin. Skin absorbs rays that convert a chemical in the skin into vitamin D. The skin of mammal is also an important sense organ. It contains sensory receptors for heat, cold, touch, pressure and pain. Nerve endings in skin keeps the animal responsive to potentially harmful factors in the environment. Skin glands. The skin of humans and other mammals contain several types of glands, and they produce different secretions. Here this is the diagram of skin of mammals, and here these are the sudoriferous glands, and these are the sebaceous or oil glands. Sudoriferous glands. Sudoriferous glands are also called as sweat glands, and they are distributed over most of the human body surface. These glands secrete sweat by a process called perspiration. Perspiration helps to regulate body temperature and maintain homeostasis, largely by the cooling effect of evaporation. In some mammals, certain sweat glands also produce pheromones. A pheromone is a chemical that an animal secretes and that communicates with other members of the same species to elicit certain behavioral responses. Sebaceous glands or oil glands. These are simple glands connected to hair follicles in the dermis. They lubricate and protect hairs by secreting sebum. Here this is the diagram of skin of mammals, and these are the sebaceous glands or oil glands, and these sebaceous glands or oil glands are connected with the hair. Functions of sebum. Sebum which is produced from the sebaceous gland. Sebum lubricates and protects the hair. Sebum acts as a permeability barrier. It acts as an emollient. Sebum is a protective agent against microorganisms. Sebum can also act as a pheromone. Coloration of mammalian skin. Following factors causes coloration mammalian skin. These includes pigments, anatomical structures and blood vessels. The pigments or anatomical structure or blood vessels give different colors to the mammalian skin. Pigments produce skin colors in mammals. Pigments like melanin are present within the cells of epidermal layer, and these are also present in hair. They are also present in specialized cells called chromatophores. Anatomical structures. Skin also has anatomical structures. These structures absorb or reflect light and produce colors. Blood vessels also produce colors. Blood present in some superficial blood vessels in the skin. The color of blood reflected through the epidermis give color to the mammalian skin. Advantages of skin coloration. Bright skin colors are produced in venomous, toxic or bad tasting animals. Skin colors help animal to hide. So skin colors may camouflage the animal. Colors can also play a role in social communication. Hair. Hair is composed of keratin filled cells that develop from the epidermis. The hair has three main parts, which includes hair shaft, root and erector pili. This is the hair shaft, this is erector pili, and this is the root of the hair. The portion of hair that protrudes from the skin is the hair shaft, and the portion embedded beneath the skin is the root. An erector pili muscle attaches to the connective tissue sheet of a hair like this. This is the erector pili muscle. Erector pili muscle attaches to the connective tissue sheet of a hair follicle surrounding the bulb of the hair root. When this muscle contracts, it pulls the hair follicle and its hair to an erect position. When this erector pili muscle contracts, it pulls the follicle and its hair to an erect position. In humans, this is named as goose bump, as these goose bumps are visible in this diagram. In other mammals, this action helps warm the animal by producing an insulating layer of warm air between erect hair and skin. If hair is erect because the animal is frightened instead of cold, the erect hair also makes the animal look larger and less vulnerable to attack. Nails and other structures. Nails are modification of the epidermis. Nails are flat horny plates on the dorsal surface of the distal digits of the primates and humans, or humans are also primates. Nails like hair are modifications of the epidermis. Nails are flat horny plates on the dorsal surface of the distal segments of the digits, for example, fingers and toes of primates. Some mammals have claws and hoofs. This is the hoof of a goat, and this is the photo of claw of grizzly bear. Other keratinized derivatives of mammalian skin are horns, and this is the horn of a goat. Bleen plates are present in toothless whales, and these are also the keratinized structures. Baleen is the apparatus toothless whales rely on to filter food from the sea. Hundreds of these flexible plates made of the structural protein keratin grow downward from a whale's upper jaw, lined up like the slats of Venetian blinds. Fitting the plates into the mouth requires a larger upper jaw, giving baleen whales a sort of upside down grin. So this is the toothless whale, and it has baleen plates. Summary of today's lecture. In this lecture, we studied about the skin of mammals. Layers of skin. Mammalian skin has three main layers: epidermis, dermis, and hypodermis. Epidermis is stratified with variety, and it has variety of cells. Dermis is thick, and hypodermis contains loose connective tissues, adipose tissues, and skeletal muscles. Skin glands are also present in the mammalian skins, which include sudoriferous glands and sebaceous glands. Coloration of mammalian skin. Various pigments give color to the mammalian skin, as well the anatomical structures and blood vessels also give color to the mammalian skin. Hairs are the characteristic features of mammals. Keratinized derivatives of mammalian skin include nails, claws and hooves, horns and baleen plates. So this was all about today's lecture. I hope you well understood this topic.